This is WBSM On Demand. It's time for South Coast Now with Chris McCarthy. Streaming live on WBSM.com and the WBSM app. Call 508-996-0500. Text us using App Chat on the WBSM app. Now, Chris McCarthy.
Good morning. Good morning. Welcome to the third and final hour of the program for today. I'm Chris McCarthy, and it's absolutely beautiful out there. Hopefully, you're enjoying the day. It's a great day to get some stuff done. Naomi and I were talking off the air before she left. Just want to remind you that if you weren't able to get through to the program, or if you don't want to put your business out there, if you have a question for her, her phone number is available on the website at the City Hall, or you can call the City Hall. They'll give you her cell phone number, and just reach out to her, right? You probably, a lot of people on that council are very nice, but Naomi is a, you never have a bad experience when you talk with Naomi, my opinion. Very pleasant person. So, she wants to hear from you. All right, folks, great New Bedford business, Mac Auto Sales. They're located 188 Rivet Street in New Bedford. They repair all makes and models. So if you need to get your car ready for the summer, as you can tell, it's coming. Today's a great day to take it down to 188 Rivet Street in New Bedford to repair your car, get a tune-up, whatever you may need. Remember, maintenance prevents a lot bigger bills in the future. So you can call Mac Auto Sales, book an appointment, 508-565-6221. They're open weekdays 9 to 5, so they're open right now. Now, if you have a foreign car, perfect. They specialize in servicing foreign automobiles. I've told you, we bring Natalie's BMW to Mac Auto Sales. If you're looking for a new-to-you car, a used car, a quality used car, you could trust Mac Auto Sales. Tell them Chris McCarthy sent you. Go down and check them out. 188 Rivet Street, New Bedford. Great sponsor of mine. So, folks, I like to concentrate on local issues. As you know, one of the big issues coming up in the city of New Bedford is how do they spend your additional tax dollars that come in the form of the Community Preservation Act. Now, that is a measure that was introduced by the Mitchell administration. It had never existed before in the city of New Bedford. It is a tax increase that you voted for. You may not have, but your neighbors voted for it. It was passed. It's been on the books now for a number of years, and the money is taken and allocated for various projects around the city. There is a CPA committee. I know some of you know this, but I just want to get everyone up to speed. There is a volunteer committee called the CPA committee, okay? They are appointed by the mayor, confirmed by the city council. They go through the applications, submit a list to the city council. They'll have a hearing coming up. They are the appointing authority. They are the allocating authority, okay? It is your tax dollars. The mayor's committee has appointed these. They make the decisions. Then everything goes to the city council. The city council can say no to individual projects. They can lower the amount of money for an individual project, but they cannot allocate more money above what the CPA committee has allocated. All right? So what I want is for you folks to go on the city website. It's very easy. You pull up Community Preservation. Go to that. They will show you the projects they have recommended. And the detailed applications are on there as well. These are millions of dollars that get spent annually. And what ends up happening is generally a project comes back year after year for additional funds. The funds are, as I said, it's your taxpayer dollars. So it is an additional property tax that you pay. And there's a state, not quite a match, but there's a state fund that comes out of the income tax, sales tax, all of that. The general fund allocates additional money. We have one in Fairhaven. There's one in Dartmouth. And there's a big one in New Bedford. So the projects that want funding that the mayor's appointees have approved is now available. It's going to go to a vote to the city council. There's a lot of worthy projects on there. However, I do believe, since it's your money and my money, because I pay income taxes, New Bedford gets them. Many of you in the audience are not property owners in the city of New Bedford, but if you pay income tax, and everyone does, just about, your money is being appropriated. So, I just want to point to a couple of projects. It's a big list. It's millions of dollars. It's been millions. Actually, well over $10 million has been allocated now out of this fund over the years. Some projects get more than others. Some projects are more worthy than others. Some projects have more political juice than others. But I do think that it is worth putting a spotlight on some of these projects. Since your city council members, you've elected them, they're going to make some judgment calls coming up. Now, I want you to look at the applications. Look through them. Don't just take my opinion for it, but I'm getting all my information from publicly available documents. So, we've had a lot of concerns, rightfully so, about halfway houses, sober houses, projects of that nature. I think that if we put it on a ballot question, the city of New Bedford, with the exception of some councilors, would vote overwhelmingly to limit the amount of sober houses. Now, what is a sober house, right? Well, a sober house is someone who had a problem with drugs and alcohol. That's a prerequisite, right? You have to have been a drug addict or an alcoholic, but now you're in some form of recovery. So you get housing. But did you know? I bet most of you didn't, because I certainly didn't, that sober houses, at least in the city of New Bedford, can apply for CPA funds. Now, not all of them, apparently, but there's one, and guess what? It has made the cut. The mayor's appointees, after going over these applications, I'm sure with a fine-tooth comb, have decided that a project that meets their approval for over $100,000. It is a program for which you must be either a drug addict, alcoholic, or spend time in a penal system. State prison, county prison, I assume a federal prison qualifies. And you have to be a woman. I guess you have to declare yourself a woman, because I can't imagine that anyone would discriminate based on the plumbing that you use, right? That you have, that God gave you. But we know that gender is a fluid concept to some people. We have a Supreme Court justice, the most recent, who said she couldn't tell what a woman is. I said, take a look in the mirror, lady. I could tell you're a woman. And I think there's some other biological clues. But she's on the Supreme Court, but she can't tell. So I don't know how the YWCA would be able to discriminate either. But anyway, the city of New Bedford, you taxpayers, are going to subsidize a living facility with your CPA money. You know that additional tax you pay that you could be putting aside for your retirement, but you're not able to because you have to pay the city? Hey, you voted for it. That's democracy. But you voted for it. Did you know when you voted for it that down the road, and down the road, I mean today, doesn't seem that far away, right, that you had the ballot referendum? But now, your taxpayers' dollars are going to go to subsidize a YWCA residential service. That's how it's listed. YWCA residential services program to the tune of over $100,000 in this round of funding. It's going to be located on County Street. It's going to be a nonprofit. So they're not going to pay taxes to the city of New Bedford. But they're going to house women and I guess men who claim they're women. How could you discriminate, right? That Johnson between your legs kind of gives it away, but we don't look at that, right? No, look above the waist, right? But if you're a person who declares themselves to be a woman, you can get housing now subsidized by the taxpayers of New Bedford. In the Commonwealth, too, by the way. And the mayor's appointees have decided this is a worthy project. So they lumped it in with all the other projects and have sent it over to the city council. Now, I'm not a city councilor. That's entirely up to your representatives. But I don't know, man, if I was I am a taxpayer of the Commonwealth, so I will just say this. I don't think it's a good idea for the city of New Bedford to subsidize the living arrangements for people who qualify only because they've been convicted of a crime and serve time in jail, or they stick a spike in their arm with heroin, right? Or they drink themselves into a stupor. And here they are. Now they qualify for subsidized housing in the city of New Bedford, specifically subsidized by an additional property tax that you pay. You have no choice. They'll put a lien on your house if you don't pay it. Do you think that's a good use of your tax? Is that what you voted for? I mean, really, I got to tell you something. I can't imagine that the town of Dartmouth would subsidize a sober house in their community. I can't imagine that the people of Fairhaven would allow CPA money to be used to subsidize a sober house. To import people with felony convictions, because that's the only way you go to prison these days. Federal, state, local. I mean, there could be some minor scrape and you have a long record. But you're going to have essentially a penal colony in the city of New Bedford, subsidized by you, the residents. I mean, really, I got to tell you, there's a reason why people are not happy with the conditions. So look, people who are in prison are there for a reason. They don't guarantee that they're going to be reformed, right? And these are not necessarily people from New Bedford. You will have people who have come out of federal prison. They'll be coming to this facility if it goes forward. There are people who were coming out of Framingham Women's Prison and also from Walpole who declare themselves women now, right? And they're going to live in the city of New Bedford, courtesy of you, the property owners. Is that something that you're happy about? Is that maybe something? I don't know. Some of you certainly are. It's a big industry. But I don't know if when you voted for the CPA for what you thought was playground equipment and artwork and other things that are good for a community to preserve the community, did you realize that the political appointees of the mayor would siphon off some of that money to the tune of over 100 grand to subsidize a sober house that is limited only to people who have had, obviously, a felony conviction or such enough of a criminal record to have gotten a prison sentence. They're now paroled from the cage into your neighborhood. And if you allow this to happen, do you think that other people aren't going to come a-claiming, banging the tin cup, asking for CPA money now that they know that it can subsidize a obviously gender-fluid facility for people whose only qualifications are they were incarcerated? Boy. And yet, you're squabbling over a business improvement district that's right down the road, quite frankly, from this intended taxpayer-subsidized sober house that'll import women or people who claim to be women from prison out of a cage onto the streets of New Bedford into a subsidized residential facility run by the YWCA. Folks, that is the kind of stuff that you can expect in the city of New Bedford. You're literally subsidizing it. 508-996-0500. Sorry to bring you the bad news, but that's what's happening. Unless the city council takes a stand against it. They have the last say. So really it's up to you to reach out to your city councilors and say, because this is going to be the vote, okay? Hopefully one of the city councilors will ask for a roll call on each individual project, right? Let's get on the record here. I know they claim, and rightfully so, they can't do much about sober houses. And that's true. But I know that they can stop subsidizing them, right? The thing you can do is not give them 100 grand of taxpayer money. Folks, elections have consequences. I'm Chris McCarthy. Stick around. We'll be right back.
Good.
Welcome back to the program. That's right, the wino and I know that there's beds available in New Bedford. The wino and I know that the New Bedford taxpayers are going to subsidize the winos. Imagine that. Look, Sean Oliver has put up a great fight against the sober house in his ward. Scott Lang has put up a great fight against the sober house in his neighborhood, right? And here you have the mayor's appointees greenlighting a sober house subsidized by you, the New Bedford taxpayers. And I'm just telling you that I don't think that would fly in Dartmouth or in Fairhaven. I don't. I really don't think that we would subsidize. I don't think anybody would do it if they were cognizant of what is going on. Elections have consequences. So you, the last guardian you have of the taxpayers' dollars are the members of your city council. If you agree with this project, I want you to call them and tell them. Certainly they've heard from a lot of people that do. A lot of people know about this money, and they know how to work the system. But if you're opposed to it, now, you may think that location's not that bad because it's nowhere near you. First of all, people who come out of prison aren't guaranteed to be reformed. Trust me on that. Talk to anybody that's been in prison. So you're going to have a dozen recently paroled state, federal, local inmates having their lifestyles subsidized by you, the taxpayer. That CPA tax, when you voted for it, did you in your wildest imagination think that it would be used to import convicted felons, women and people who claim they're women, to live in the city of New Bedford, just above your business district? You know, some of those people, they might shoplift. Some of those people might relapse. And I think it's great that you folks in New Bedford are willing to subsidize the lifestyle of those people whose only qualification is that they've broken the law or shot up dope with your tax dollars. Because you know what? When you take them to New Bedford, well, it's less likely that they'll be here in Fairhaven. Unless they take the bus over to shoplift at Walmart. Or take the bus over to steal a car here in Fairhaven. So as goes New Bedford, goes the region. So maybe as I think this thing through, it's just a bad idea for everybody. Look, you make a mistake in life, it's unfortunate, but you do have to pay the consequences. But now, the CPA is saying, come to New Bedford. If you're from Saugus or Revere, Providence, Rhode Island, come to New Bedford. We'll give you a place to stay, and the taxpayers will subsidize it. And it'll be right up there on County Street. Is that a good idea? Is that the direction that you think New Bedford should go in? Do you think that your peers in the suburbs, Fairhaven, Dartmouth, would offer the same sort of taxpayer-funded subsidy to an exclusively criminal class of people? Do you? Do you realize what's going to happen is they're going to open this place up and they don't pay taxes, unlike you, and they're going to import people from the state and federal prison system into New Bedford. Now, I'm sure some of those people are done with, you know, murder, mayhem, shoplifting, armed robberies, selling drugs. Remember, to get a state prison sentence, you got to be a seriously dangerous person. And there are women out there, and maybe the CPA committee should have talked to a couple of the grizzled veterans on their police department to ask them if there's a difference between male and female criminals. Or can women be just as dangerous as men? You know, women can commit murder. Women can sell drugs. Women can commit armed robberies. That Bonnie and Clyde business model is very much still in existence. I listen to the Scanner. Some of you do as well. The Bonnie and Clyde business arrangement, the business model of Bonnie and Clyde, is a tried and true. model for some limited success as a criminal. So, trust me, these darlings who are going to be here with your subsidy, you're their potential victim. 508-996-0500. I'm just trying to alert you folks. I'm like pulling the fire alarm here, right? That you've got to reach out. Politics is a contact sport. You got to reach out. And if you don't want your tax dollars to subsidize sober houses, you got to speak up now. Because some people in that city council are just going to vote for stuff when it comes in front of them. Others will pay a little more attention. But it's up to you. Do you really think $100,000? And remember, there are always more worthy projects that don't get funded because other projects have more political juice. That's what this is about. And so they're able to get on the list for your money. It's amazing. It's really amazing. 508-996-0500. Folks, the hot weather is coming up. It's already kind of arriving, but the next thing to come will be that really stifling humidity. But not if you act proactively today. American Pride Properties has the ultimate solution for your heating and cooling needs. It's called ductless mini splits. Mini splits are an unparalleled, they're really unparalleled in their efficiency, and they're customizable. They're quiet, best of all. So if you want to sleep comfortably as the weather gets hotter and more humid, all you have to do, call Justin Case, that's his real name, at American Pride. Tell him you need the mini split system at your place. Tell him Chris McCarthy sent you. They service all of southeastern Massachusetts and Rhode Island. So if you're hearing my voice, they can help you out. Plus, they offer financing options to fit any budget. Unfortunately, you don't get CPA funding for this, but you can get really convenient financing options. It's never been easier to upgrade your HVAC system at American Pride. Call Justin Case at American Pride. Write this down, 774-992-8982. Again, 774-992-8982, or you can find them on the web at appgroupllc.com. Fill out the contact form. Justin Case will get right back to you. American Pride Properties Group, act proactively for your future. We got some people on hold. I'm sure they've got a different opinion, maybe not, from me on subsidizing sober houses. So you have members of the city councils, members of the community fighting against sober houses. And here you have the mayor's appointees greenlighting a $100,000, more than $100,000 subsidy for a newfangled tax-free sober house. They don't have to pay property taxes. Unlike you, they're getting a subsidy from literally right out of your wallet. See what the people have to say. Good morning. Thanks for calling.
Hi.
Hi.
My name's Corrine.
Hi, Corrine.
And I have been listening to your station for a few weeks. I don't live in New Bedford, so I don't know if I'm, you know, if you have any interest in knowing what people are.
I do.
Feedback.
I don't live in, I have property. I don't pay tax in New Bedford. I have property in Fairhaven. So sure, we want to hear what you have to say. Tell us what's going on.
Well, you know, I have to tell you, I don't have a drinking problem. I have a thinking problem. I started going to AA's here on Martha's Vineyard just because I was just at the end of my rope. I had been going out with a guy that was into doing drugs and stuff, and I got sober. Not because I was a big drinker, not because I was a big drug person, because I'm an athlete. I'm a figure skater by trade, and you know, you can't really do that kind of stuff if you're actively, you know, trying to keep balance and all that. But what I've learned by going to meetings here on the island is that very intelligent, very educated people fall prey to alcoholism.
Yes.
Because it's so easily, you know, available. But they are very often, from what I have experienced over, I've been going now for 12 years or something, because I get like, I get a boost. I get inspired listening to people
yes.
about how they recover from their addictions. And I know that I'm not really, I'm not really one of them, but I am anyways, because I'm, if some is good, more is better. So I'm a workaholic. I love beautiful things. I collect, I have way too much stuff in my house. You know, it's like the, it's, if some is good, more is better.
Okay.
And I think that people that go into jail, you know, should if they did something wrong, but I can almost 100% sort of be sure that they were under the influence of drugs and alcohol or one or the other
right.
when they were doing shit like that. Excuse my language. Oops. I don't know if I'm on that.
So we can't have you swear on the air, but I do appreciate that you feel that way. I'm just wondering if that then qualifies you, not you, but people who've gone to jail for a taxpayer-funded subsidy. I mean, they've already paid for your jail, right? Three hots and a cot. But I don't know. I welcome your call. You just have to clean up the language for the next call. And you're welcome here anytime. I do enjoy calls from the islands. I've told you folks that our audience has expanded out to the islands down the Cape, and of course to the west, to Fall River, places like that. So, but yeah, folks, the idea that you're going to subsidize living facilities for people whose sole qualification to get a claim on your money is that they committed a felony bad enough to have had to be incarcerated, and now they come out, they're a female, or they claim to be a female, and they get you to pay for their housing. So it's a really interesting idea, and it's going down if you don't raise a stink about it to your city council. 508-996-0400. Stick around, we'll be right back.
Well, now that's just the start of a well-deserved overdue binge. Meanwhile, back in the city, certain people are starting to cringe. His lawyers are calling his parents. His girlfriend doesn't know what to think. His partners are studying their options. He's just singing harder and drinks.
Welcome back to the program. Just singing and ordering drinks, right? Hey, look, some of the most interesting people I know spent decades in prison, and rightfully so. And there's no doubt about it. People who have drug addiction, drug problems, alcohol problems, they got great stories. They're very interesting. You know, I'll buy them all. I'd buy them all a drink, but you know, you can't really do that with them. Sit down and drink coffee with them. And again, I'm being dead serious here. I've got some very good friends, some who've shed their mortal coil now. But look, Jerry Tillinghast and I were pretty close friends. He was in prison for 33 years. He did a lot of bad things, no doubt about it. Other people who were around, and I have no problem being in their company and being seen socially with them because I think they're reformed now. But they were dangerous people, and they may still be a little bit. But they've grown out of it, if that's the way to put it. I don't know. I'm not a sociologist. I really have no experience other than just having social acquaintances and friends with people who have, you know, had drug problems or went to jail, things like that. I'm just wondering whether, how do you, on one hand, say that you want to keep sober houses out of the city of New Bedford, while the other hand is subsidizing them, right? I think that this is a protected class of people. We know that. So don't you think that it sends a schizophrenic message that also makes your decisions vulnerable to charges of targeting sober houses who aren't part of the political elite, right? That political cliques that qualify for city funding, they get them. But if you don't, if you're not part of the political class, if you're not a connected person in the city of New Bedford, then you are verboten, right? They don't want you here. But if you are part of the political elite and somebody's making a paycheck off of it, then not only is the carpet rolled out for you, but we even subsidize it. So again, I think that, look, Leo Choquette is dealing with it up in Ward 1. Brad Markey was dealing with it up in Ward 1. Linda Morad has been dealing with it up in Ward 1, a sober house. These are here without any government subsidies. But now the city council is being asked by the mayor's appointees to subsidize to the tune of over $100,000 on this tranche of funding a facility that is exclusively for women or people who claim they're women or believe they're women who have been incarcerated. Now they're going to import them into the city of New Bedford. I just think it's a bad idea. But it's up to you, folks. Elections have consequences. 508-996-04. The other thing is the county of Bristol, Bristol County, wants you New Bedford taxpayers to subsidize the construction, the reconstruction of the courthouse. Right? Did you realize that your tax dollars, when you voted for the CPA, would go to subsidize county buildings? When the county is flush with ARPA money. In fact, they're going to do a little bit of a match for the taxpayers' dollars out of New Bedford. They're going to use a little bit of ARPA money on this project. They have plenty of money. They could fund it all themselves. But you folks are going to subsidize a county-owned building. Isn't that amazing? Folks, we have a couple phone lines open. If you'd like to call, you can. 508-996-0500. I got to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
But then I got a guitar, found a job in a bar, playing acid rock till I was numb. Tell me, where are the flashbacks they all warned us would come? We are the people they couldn't figure out.
Welcome back to the program. I'm Chris McCarthy. Where are those flashbacks they promised us would come? Thanks for calling. You're on the air.
Seeing the time is going to be quick. When you talk to the mayor tomorrow,
yes, sir.
Could you ask him how could he support something like this that doesn't add to the tax basis? It doesn't make sense.
Doesn't make sense at all, right? I mean, again, right, but these are his appointees.
It doesn't add to the taxes.
Nothing. And
right,
it imports
how can
bad
support
people.
Something like that.
It's a great question. We're going to ask the mayor. The mayor, thanks for the call. The mayor will be here tomorrow at 11 o'clock, at 11 exactly. And there's a lot to talk about with him, so probably won't get through all the topics, but we'll certainly get to this. His appointees are allocating $100,000 to a nonprofit to buy a property on County Street and to subsidize it, right? To make it for people, women, or people who say they're women, who are formerly incarcerated and in some form of recovery from drugs and alcohol. Is that really what you thought the CPA was going to be used for? I remember that campaign. And do you think that that's the best use of that dollars? The other thing is that, as I pointed out here, there's a lot of projects on there. Go online and look at this. I do my best to spotlight it, but you have different values than I do and different concerns. But just think about what I'm saying. You have an abundance of sober houses in the city of New Bedford. And the mayor has told me nobody runs them right, okay? Yet here we have a situation where his appointees have green-lighted a $100,000, over actually $100,000, tranche of funding. And remember, there's never as much money as there are requests, okay? Every year, stuff gets funded, not at all or below the initial request by the CPA. They have to make value judgments, right? It's a volunteer committee. You can get on there, too. There's a vacancy. You might want to get on there. But anyway, folks, I've bothered you long enough for today. Up next, Bill O'Reilly, then Barry Richard. I'll be back tomorrow, God willing. Go to